Now, with increasing global population and so less land to grow more crops that are needed for all the food demand that's likely to come up, we've got to find new ways of increasing plant yields with what we already have. One company that's addressing this is Plant Impact. We're pleased now to be talking to the Chief Executive, Peter Blezard. Pete, just give us a rundown of what Plant Impact does exactly.
Well, thanks for asking me in today. We're looking at global needs, global issues, and we feel we have a global solution for crop enhancement that's increasing yields in, we would think, all crops worldwide. We've spent the last 8 years doing hundreds of trials in horticulture. Horticulture is the salads and the vegetable crops, so we started in high level. And technically what we do is remove the stress from that crop. That allows the yield to come through. Most yield loss is through, they call it abiotic. It's actually climatic stress. It's too hot, too cold, too dry. So we alleviate, as a company, we alleviate that stress. But the strap line we want people to understand is we are in crop enhancement.
So there's two facets to this. There's crop nutrition, which is, yes, a lot of what you're talking about there, but you've also got a crop protection aspect to this as well, haven't you?
Exactly right. What we're focused on, and I want to impress you on this, is we are focused on crop enhancement nutrition. That is with two technologies, Inca, which is a new way of moving calcium through a plant, it's patented worldwide, and the other way is PINT, PI nitrogen technology, which is a completely new delivery system for nitrogen. Now, don't believe me, the USDA, United States Department of Agriculture, is writing a scientific paper on this, and most of our pipeline that's coming behind that is all based on crop enhancement. Having said that, what you've asked me is, we have a crop protection product called bug oil, which is a food-grade pesticide, and that's currently going through the pesticide legislation required to have it registered both in UK and the USA. So we're working with, they call it the CRD in UK, and it's the EPA in America.
That's registration, but what about regulation?
Well, we need to register through regulations a pesticide product. The other crop enhancement products are all registered now for sale, meeting current EU and American fertilizer regulations. We're also completely registered with our technologies in Brazil. And these are our focus markets, and we want to focus on Brazil, America, Northern Europe, and also we have a sales office in Middle East. We're very, very keen on Middle East as a market. We've learned a lot through the Middle East, through different stressful conditions and climatic conditions.
The company has reached an interesting point. You've just appointed a new chairman, yeah, which I understand has the potential to transform Plant Impact.
Yeah, well, I believe companies are not successful, people are. And this is a very successful person. His name's Dr. David Jones. His previous life, he was the head of business development for Syngenta, part of their executive committee. And after that, he joined Arista Life, the largest private chemical company in the world in agriculture. And now, you know, I'm privileged to say he's become our chairman. It's hot off the press. It's been announced today to the stock market. He will help mentor the management team. He will bring some disciplines perhaps we've had to grow up to, but Plant Impact's only 8 years old. We're just growing into that, and you're right, this is a platform for change.
Apart from disciplines, what's he going to do? What's his plan of action going to be?
His plan of action is to take us into very large crops to make a step change, crops like soya, take us into larger companies and start to think with probably a bigger vision. Having said that, I don't think I'm lacking in that, because I still see a 200 million turnover company at a minimum. It's just taking time. I believe the model's right, but it takes time in agriculture.
You mentioned your new chairman comes from Syngenta, amongst other companies.
Yeah.
You announced a collaboration with the Brazilian arm of Syngenta, and you said back in November last year that it has tremendous potential, but investors should be patient for the results.
Yeah, and I never want to give the impression that this is a quick win. Of course, we're on the public market, people come in and take short-term bets. This is a long-term play. Syngenta, when they work on a business plan, they are many, many years in planning, probably 10 or 15 years looking at new products. So the reason I said caution, and it's not just down to Syngenta. When we met them in Brazil, they spent over a year just working with someone like PI to look at what technologies we had. And it is a trial they're doing. I mean, I wouldn't want to call it a collaboration with Syngenta. It's a big trial they're putting together for us. Big investment for them and a big investment for us. We sent a container of products down and we're in a 4,000 hectare trial phase with Syngenta, but this could take 1 to 2 years. So we have to be patient, and it's on crops that we haven't worked on before, like soya. Now there's 21 million hectares of soya in Brazil, so the numbers exponentially could be explosive for a company like Plant Impact, but please be patient.
I was going to say, I mean, Syngenta is an $11 billion company, and here we are talking to a small cap company based in the UK. How significant is this for you?
Oh, it's extremely significant, but we have multiple partners. We are talking to 4 of the top 10. And the reason being for is we have novel nutrition. It's crop enhancement. Most of it's patented. We don't screen molecules to bring a new product out over 10 years. We look at making a very novel cocktail that actually does what it says on the tin.
Who are your competitors in this market?
I like to look at everyone from a Syngenta down to be a collaborator. We are working with some fertilizer groups blending our technology in dry powder fertilizers. We are looking at other groups want to blend our technology in liquids. And then we want to sell direct. And then we have multiple distributors selling on our behalf. And I don't care if they go branded product, own branded product, as long as we move product. And we have a hybrid approach. We're happy to do a license deal and go global with that. And we're also intent on investing in our own sales force. And Plant Impact will be out there as a brand. Indeed it is. We're in over 25 countries now.
You don't make a profit yet. Do you?
No.
And you had cash, 3.3 million net raised in the markets through placings in mid-2009.
That's
how far
right.
through that are you? What's the cash burn rate like?
I don't really want to talk about cash burn too much unless you're going to push me on it, because remember, we're in a very strong drive for revenue growth. Our sales are doubling year on year, and I foresee that to happen for a few years, certainly coming into the future. But we have cash coming onto the bottom line from sales. We've now passed over 7 figures in sales, which is, we never celebrated that. We've just had our first 6-figure order in from Holland, which was well over £350,000, one order. The repeat orders, we are growing. We've got the Bug Oil Moundstone payments to come in, which is well over 1.7 million. So we have cash to come. We also have potential industry cash. And we did turn cash down in December because we didn't feel it was good for the shareholders. So we have several avenues over the next few months. But Mike Pantelli, my financial director, does not spend money too fast. He keeps a very tight rein on financials. And Mike is 15 years in biotech. He's seen it all go wrong. He's a very good ally to me in doing the strategy, but we always cost everything out, so we work within the resource we have.
Just want to quickly follow up one other aspect. Allenby Capital has a speculative buy on your stock with a price of 53 pence and what it says is a cautious valuation.
Yeah.
This is some distance from where we are at the moment, around about 26 pence a share.
Yeah.
What do you say to that?
Well, I think we're brokers should be very careful and not put speculative buy. They should put strong buy. This company's got a lot of unlocked value. I keep trying to say, we're only 8 years old. In agriculture, it takes any large company 8 to 10 years to roll out one technology. We're rolling out several. Now, if we were a one-trick pony, that would be also dangerous. We have a focus on Inca and pint technology crop enhancement. Bug oil's done. That's worth 20 million to us. We aristolize right. science over the next 10 years. So that one's a lottery ticket waiting to come in. What do I say to them? There's a lot of people in cities certainly looking for a more significant upside than £1 and £2 a share, and I am as well. We are going to build a sustainable business that delivers that.
One final question. As Chief Executive, where do you see Plant Impact in 1 or 2 years' time? Clearly, this is a company that's developing now quite fast.
In 2 years' time, I see us in profit. In 2 years' time, I see us in Brazil. I see us in America. I see us in crop enhancement, and as I see us as a brand leader coming with new technologies globally.
Okay, Pete, well, we look forward to seeing how the company progresses, and of course with your new chairman as well. That's Peter Blezard, the Chief Executive of Plant Impact.